Hello, and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, what I'm hoping to do for you in this video is to let you know if you should be interested in this. This is Star Tycoon. Build your galactic corporation from Good Games Publishing. Now, I got to see this game in action at the Gamma Trade Show, and I do have to thank Good Games Publishing for letting us take a review copy home from that. Now, note the shrink is cut on this, but this is how the game comes. And yes, there is box lift when you get it. And that's because when you take the cardboard out, you'll still get a nice sealed box. So that's just for shipping purposes. The game doesn't normally look like that. Now, this is an economic game with a sci-fi theme designed by Peter and Elkira Sanderson. Now, I have not played this game. I know the bare minimum about it. But I am looking forward to it because I love Good Games Publishing. We have reviewed many of their games in the past, and I have yet to play a bad game by them. So I am looking forward to see if Star Tycoon doesn't break that trend, and I don't think it will. Step one, though, is going to be to open this box, so let's get to it. All right, here you have the box for Star Tycoon. As I just mentioned, there is some box lift, but that is just for shipping purposes because there's a bunch of punch boards we're going to have to go through. So just show off that, and we'll show off the back here, and I got to say, it's looking pretty. It's got a nice aesthetic to it. Get to see that better inside the box. As you can tell, this is a fairly new one, right? We've got their catalog from Good Games Publishing. Check out their other games. They make some fantastic games. We have the rule book. Nice size, lays out nice, kind of creepy corporate guy here, which fits in an economic game. This is obviously a card-driven game with a variable market. And like many good economic games, it's going to be based on how buying and selling, and the more you sell, the lower the price will go on these various goods. There's some golden rules here, which is interesting. Looks like very clear iconography. Rule book is a combination of single layer, single column and dual. Text is a little smaller than I'd like, though I got to say this guide to profit. I like that. There's some nice theming here. Then how to play. Okay. So this is like a little key points. I like that. Purchase planets, purchase development, purchase resources, trade resources, get points, form partnerships. I like that. It's a nice summary of the game right there. And then it gets into the detail of how to do all of that. Very cool. So we're just going to flip through this pretty quickly. There's some edge cases. You can take out loans. You know it's an economic game when it says take a loan as a free action. I'm amused. Here's you getting into the various card types. This looks like there's a lot going on. Quite a few symbols here. Wow. Bonus point tiles. An example turn. That's always good to see. How to set up your player area. I like that. That there's a suggestion. Solo mode. Important nowadays. People dig that. And various game variants. With more players. Interesting. You can play with 5 or 6. You can play longer. You can play teams. Very cool. And a nice quick reference. Always appreciated. Punch boards. I like that iconography. This is clean. Oh, they're all the same. Okay, so we have 3 identical punch boards with the various goods, I'm assuming, that you're buying and selling and trading here. Looks, there are some that are different shapes. I don't know. There's some skulls. There's lightning bolts. Looks like spaceships, science, probably energy. They are double-sided with pretty much the same thing on each side, except one. Oh, there's a there. They're not the same. Okay. I missed one difference here. There's possibly a first player token. There's like a robot token on one of these cards. Okay. I don't know if there's more punch boards under it, but here is the Galactic Market, which, yes, is dual-layered. And no warpage. Look at that. That's nice. Nice to see. Ah, insert. Look at this. Look at this. This is pretty. There's literally like a plastic insert in here. I was not expecting that. Sorting everything. Here you've got the, I have to guess, first player marker. I like it. It's a giant hand holding the globe. Like, take control. Oh, it's an alien hand, too. That's, sorry, my camera refuses to focus on it. No? Not even going to try? All right. Fine. So yeah, giant hand, it's got like scales on it, so it's not a human hand. Cute touch. You know what, I'm not even bother putting that back in a bag. There's a spot for it right here. These are your market trackers. which we're just going to do a real quick. It's a pretty good fit. It's not tight. There is some wiggle room there, but that's going to stop it from getting bumped. And then there's one down here, which is probably the purple one. So there's your different market trackers. Oh, there's two sides. Okay. Oh, interesting. So there's probably like a side where it can move, and then there's probably a side where it's locked. Cool. Haven't played it. Production quality here is very nice. There's one punch. Oh, it's the same. Replacement blurry token. I don't know why there's a replacement version. Lots of cards. They do have the quick release. One card deck. Hands on the back. Tart Institute. Hex. I'm really digging the aesthetic here. Very clear. Bunch of hammer cards. Oh, in different levels. So there's like level 3 hammer cards. Solar array, biodome, astro drills. So these might be things you can invest in. And then some level 2s. Yeah, a whole bunch of level 2s. And I'm going to guess some level 1s. So I'm just going to flip these quickly. They show victory points at the end. There's some goods at the bottom. All kinds of ways these. I don't know if these are resources you have to spend. I'm getting more and more intrigued. Like, these cards are fascinating to me. I love the iconography. Artwork's solid. It's very clear, crisp. I was about to say I don't see any duplication, but there are some cards there are multiple copies of that have the same artwork, which makes sense. But I didn't see those until I went pretty deep in. So I'm going to assume that deck's supposed to be separate from the others. All right, we're going to go by backs. So we have hammers with homes. I'm going to guess like starting cards. We've got that token that we keep seeing everywhere, the happy robot. Bank loan. Okay, these are bank loan cards. With the terms and conditions on the back. Okay, so summary cards with this funky happy robot guy. Then bank loans, which I'm just amused by the amount of terms and conditions on the back of these. Looks like it's 5 credits or 5 money. Exclamation marks, which I'm going to guess are events, because that's usually what they are. Yep, market, flip, overtime, laundering. Don't know what houses are. We have houses. Systems. System cards. We have briefcase cards. Oh. These look like different types of those building. The things are on the other side this time. Some really nice artwork on some of these. And more handshake cards. So those were in the bottom up here. Yes, so I'm going to put those together. One more set of cards. There's nice insert, clear plastic insert with spots for 3 different decks of cards. And as far as I can tell, this is going to hold all those resource tokens. I'm going to take that out last. Okay, we have more level 1 hammers. Which look the same as the other ones. And I'm just going to put those with the rest. And we have planets. All the rest are planets. And yes, they look like planets. Okay. That's everything. Now, let's take a quick look at this. What's this? Yeah, that's exactly what I thought. Is it tape? Nope, just pops off. Resource holder. That is awesome. I love it. Like, and it's got a lid, so they're not going to pop everywhere. You can just pass this around, and I'm assuming that's where these are going to go. Love it. All fits nice in the box. Good work. Good Games Publishing. This board is so nice. And yeah, that's really going to sit flush once these are gone. I'm going to pretend these aren't in here just to prove that the box is going to sit nice and tight. Yeah, look at that. Perfect fit. Everything's going to stay nice. You don't have to do my usual trick of putting the punch board under the insert. There you go. What you get in the box for Star Tycoon from Good Games Publishing. A sci-fi economic game about trying to rule the universe through commerce. A market manipulation economic game from Good Games Publishing. I am impressed. I had no idea what I was going to get into when I opened this up. I had seen the game out on display at a game convention, at a first look event, but that did not have the insert out, so I had no clue. You got an awesome dual air board, a ton of different cards. Couldn't tell you how to use them, but the iconography looks fantastic. I dig the artwork. The game just has a very clean look to it. The iconography looks great. It does remind me of some other games. Fantastic Factories comes to mind for that very clear iconography. This looks great. I dig economic games, especially unique ones. I know some people dig the sci-fi theme, so that's also a nice touch. And I'm just going to call it out. I do notice there's another company on here called Warp Core. So my guess is Good Games is probably localizing this from Warp Core, but it does look like it's a collaboration. Yes, so the designer is Warp Core and the publisher is Good Games Publishing. Sorry, I didn't call that out at the beginning. So, ASA, I'm looking forward to checking this one out. When I do, I'll be sharing my thoughts on social media, where I can be found everywhere as Tabletop Bellhop, one word. And you can head over to our blog, tabletopbellhop.com. The only problem now, though, is I am out of coffee. I've done a whole bunch of reviews and unboxings today. It's been a long day. So you can help give me a pick-me-up by heading to coffee, ko-fi.com/tabletopbellhop. Buy me a brew. I'll share a picture of it online, tell you what I'm drinking. Thanks for joining me for this unboxing. I need a break. Good day and game on.